Sairam children, welcome back to maths class. Children, we have already done with our word problem questions, right? Today, in this class, we are going to revise chapter number 7, fraction. And also, teacher is going to show you fraction in the form of an activity through craft papers. Okay, are you ready? So children, let us start. What is fraction? A fraction is a part of a whole. It represents one or more equal parts of a whole object. Correct, children? I have given an example of chapati, right? And we have divided it into equal parts. Correct? When we divide into equal parts, that part is known as a fraction. How do we write fraction in numbers? We write fractions in numbers as number of parts selected upon total number of equal parts of the whole. Correct? Number of parts selected is known as numerator, and total number of equal parts of the whole is known as denominator. So it is written as numerator upon denominator. Children, we have learnt about cardinal numbers and ordinal numbers, right? Cardinal numbers are here 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, correct? And ordinal numbers are the numbers which show position, okay, or place. Here, like 3rd, 4th position, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th. Then we have here 11th, 12th, 13th, 14th, 15th, 16th, 17th, 18th, 19th, 20th. Why these are important? Because when we write a fraction, which is how we write numerator upon denominator, correct? Now when we are writing it in words, in numerator we write the cardinal numbers and the denominator represents ordinal numbers. Okay, that is why it is important. Let us move towards one more concept, which is half. Okay, now what is half? If you divide a whole thing into two equal parts, then each part is called half of the whole. Correct? Like for example, you can see children, here we have a cake and it is divided into two equal parts. Correct? So each part represents half. Now this part is half, which we write it as 1 upon 2. Now this part of the cake is also half, and we write it as 1 upon 2. Right children, you can see here there is a circle, okay, and it is divided into two parts, and one of the part is colored in green. So it will represent as half. Each part will represent half. Now we have learned also about 1/3, correct? So what is 1/3? If you divide a whole thing into three equal parts, then each part is 1/3 of the whole. Right children, here you can see yummy pizza, correct? And this pizza is divided into three equal parts. Okay, one pizza is a whole, then it is divided into three equal parts. Now each part will represent 1/3 of the whole, right? So this part is here, you can see 1/3. The other parts also will represent the same. This is also 1/3, 1 upon 3. And this is also 1 upon 3, this part. Okay, children? The next concept that we have seen is 1/4. Okay, it says 1/4, correct? So it means 4 equal parts, right? So if you divide a whole thing into 4 equal parts, then each part is 1/4 of the whole. Now here you can see burger, correct? It is one burger. But if there are 4 friends, okay, if you want to divide among 4 friends, So you will divide it into four parts, right? So each part will represent 1/4 of the whole. So here children, so this is 1/4, okay? This part is also 1/4, this part is also 1/4, and this part is also 1/4. Children, here you can see one more example of 1/3 and 1/4. See children, here the circle, here the first one, it is divided into three equal parts, and the shaded portion is 1/3, right? And on the other side we have one more circle which is divided into four equal parts, and the shaded part is 1/4. Children, next in this chapter we have learned about collection. Okay, now if we want to find fraction of a collection, how we will find? We can find by dividing, right? So what we have to divide? For example, if we want to find half of a collection, children, here you can see cards are there. How many cards do we have? 6 cards, right? If we want to find half of this collection, okay, because we don't have only one card, we have many cards here, 6 cards we have, so it is a collection. If you want to find the fraction, okay, if you want to find what is half of this collection, how we will do it? We have to divide it by 2, okay, correct? So it is 6 divided by 2, okay, we know division. 2 what's a 6? 2 threes are 6. So half of 6 car is equal to 3 cars, right children? See here, this will be the half of the collection, correct? Next is finding 1/3 of a collection. The same way, okay, to find 1/3 of a collection, we have to divide it by 3. Okay, so here you can see there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 apples are there. If I want to find what is 1/3 of 9 apples, we have to divide it by 3. So it will be 9 divided by 3. Okay, we will do the division. 3 was a 9, 3 threes are 9. Okay, so children, 1/3 of 9 apples is equal to 3. So 1, 2, 3, this is 1/3 of the collection. This will also be 1/3 of the collection. This will also be 1/3 of the collection. Got it, children? Next is finding 1/4 of a collection. Children, here how many samosas do we have? 8 samosas, right? If we want to find what is 1/4 of 8 samosas, we have to divide it by 4, correct? So it is 8 divided by 4. So we will divide here. 4 2's are 8, right children? So 1/4 of 1/4 of 8 samosas is equal to 2. See children here. This is 1/4 of the collection. Okay, 2 samosas. Right children? Children, now I will show you a small activity with the help of craft papers. Okay, it will help you to understand the concept of fraction. So children, here I have few craft papers and I have cut them into different shapes. As you can see children here, I have one square, a triangle and a circle. So with the help of the craft papers, we are going to see some more examples of fractions. So first we are going to start with triangle. So first I am going to fold this triangle in between, okay, and then I'm going to open it. You can see, children, here I have got two parts like this. Children, each part is a half, correct? So how do we write half? It is one part upon how many total parts are there? Two parts, correct? So it is 1/2. This side also is 1/2. Same way, let us now fold the circle. When I'm going to fold the circle, it should be exactly on each other so that we get two equal halves. Yes, children, it will look this way, correct? So this part is 1/2. This side also it is 1/2, correct? So each part, because I have divided the circle into two equal parts, so each part is 1/2. This we have learned. Now let us take a square. Okay, now children, I am going to fold this paper or this square into three parts, that two three equal parts. Okay, so let us fold. Okay, now you can see, children, I have got here three equal parts, correct? Now let us see what does each part will represent. Now this part, the first one, okay, what it will be? One part upon how many equal parts are there? Three parts. So it will be 1/3. Now children, what if I am going to shade two parts? And one more part I am going to shade. So children, what about this two? How we are going to represent the shaded part? How we are going to write it? It will be written as 2/3, correct? Because two parts are shaded upon how many total parts are there? There are three total parts, correct? So it will be written as 2/3 or 2/3. So this part only is known as 2/3, whereas the part which is not shaded, you can see here, children, the part is not shaded. So this part, we can, how we will write it? As 1/3 or 1/3, correct? So it is, this is shaded and not shaded is equal to 1/3, because only one part is not shaded and there are three equal parts. Children, so you can also do this activity in your home. You can take craft papers and you can just make folds that are equal. Okay, how many parts you are going to make, all the parts should be equal. Now here you can see I have made 8 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, 8 equal parts I have made. If I want to say what is the, if I want to shade, okay, one part. So how you will write it in fraction? It will be written as
1 upon how many total parts are there? 8 parts. So it is 1 upon 8. Correct?
Children, I hope you have understood the chapter fraction very well, and you can also take craft papers and you can find out what is half, one third, one fourth, and you can go on, you can make equal parts and you can make find the fraction. So children, thank you. Have a good day.